This is in your most recent research. It's about the bond market. Where do you get that downside protection from if the equity market falls out of bed? What's the answer, Ben?
Well, it's a difficult question. With all difficult questions, I think it depends. Let me say first that the underlying trend here is a positive one. Based on fundamental factors, you have sprightly early cycle dynamics. It's well flagged that the Fed has providing ample monetary policy support. The balance of risks on the upside and downside is pretty good here. But it's a portfolio construction headache in the sense that your usual sources of protection are no longer active. So the most impressive thing of the last month has been just the fact that bond yields do not move. You had a point where U.S. equities were down 4 or 5%. Bond yields, 10-year treasuries were down 2 basis points. And so that negative stock bond correlation is no longer a source of balance in portfolios. And the question is, how do you get that? So the answer, I think, is that you have to assemble a set of more constructive, favorable correlations in your portfolio. One is credit. So if you're taking a pro-risk view, positions in credit are not perfectly correlated. And in fact, because of the Fed put, because of the implicit and explicit guarantees from the Fed, credit has been much less sensitive to swings in the equity market. So that's one. The second is the dollar. So everybody's talking about how the dollar is going to depreciate in trend terms. It's also the thing that has the most favorable correlation when things go wrong. So if everything goes right, the dollar is going to continue depreciating somewhat. If it goes wrong, there's no limit to how strong the dollar can get. So you have to use those correlations as a hedge in your portfolio.
Ben, I saw yesterday that hedge funds bet on technologies flipped. I'm going to give credit to Zero Hedge. I frankly, folks, can't remember where I saw it. Ben, how important is it to go with hedge funds in their belief or to bet contrarian to them? Which way does that cut?
Well, average returns for hedge funds over the last 20 years have not been spectacular.
Yeah.
So maybe you'll take that as a contrarian indicator. But I think you have to focus on what those directional trends are. And I don't think we're not looking at that as a singular indicator here.
What is your indicator on technology funds? Folks, Ray Dalio coming up this afternoon, Catherine Burton with a blistering article this morning on Bridgewater as well. I mean, is that the salvation for hedge funds to go the other way and pile into tech?
I think it raises an important question for us in terms of, are growth stocks going to continue to lead here and the relatively narrow foundation on the U.S. market? I think this actually feeds into the same concept of where is protection in your portfolio. And, typically we think about the U.S. equity market as the high quality, high return on equity market, and hence somewhat defensive when things go wrong. Actually, that's not the case these days. The volatility, especially when tech is leading, is very much centered around the U.S. And as such, it's a higher beta market. So I think what that's telling you is that, as you diversify internationally, that those equity positions, you're looking a little bit less in the U.S., a little bit more outside for that balance.